Indian Navy's frontline stealth frigate INS Talwar has arrived in Kenya, with an aim to strengthen ties further. To unblock the sale of F-35 fighter jets to Turkey, US officials have proposed to formally keep the S-400 missiles on Turkish territory, but transfer their control to a US-controlled base in southern Turkey. India has issued a NOTAM warning for a range of 1,715 kilometers from 25th to 30th September over the Bay of Bengal. Indian firm BonV Aero has completed a hover flight test of its high-altitude drone at 19,000 feet, carrying a 30 kilograms payload, and has set a world record for UAV operations at high altitudes. Adani Defence is preparing to double its small arms ammunition production capacity at its Kanpur plant to 300 million rounds per year. Big Bang Boom Solutions has unveiled its Vajra shot handheld anti-drone jammer, which has the ability to adapt its interference output frequency through software that allows it to effectively neutralize a wide range of modern drones. ISRO is planning to build a sea barge for the recovery of solid boosters of the upcoming next-generation launch vehicle rocket. An old problem that has long haunted the MQ-9B fleet is likely to have caused the recent loss of a leased Indian Navy MQ-9B drone in the Bay of Bengal last week. The crash took place after the battery of the drone got depleted during flight, and this took place after a reported double generator failure, which is a recurring problem with the MQ-9 fleet in service with the US. Officials have said that the drone has disintegrated on crashing into the sea, and will be difficult to recover given the depths involved. The Navy will not have to bear the costs, as the leased drone was being operated and maintained by the manufacturer General Atomics. Several African and Middle Eastern countries have requested the Indo Russian Rifles Private Limited for carrying out trials of the Indian manufactured AK-203 rifles. The surge in inquiries from these countries are mainly due to the Western sanctions imposed on Russian arms manufacturers that have created a lucrative opportunity for India. The company is actively engaging with these countries to showcase the capabilities of the AK-203 and explore opportunities for future collaborations. After undergoing a preliminary design review approximately 3 years ago, the DRDO is steadily progressing towards the completion of the critical design review for its next-generation main battle tank design that is intended for the Indian Army's FRCV program. The DRDO has been diligently refining the design to meet the specific requirements outlined in the Army's request for information tender, and officials have confirmed that it will incorporate advanced anti-drone technologies to neutralize aerial threats effectively, and next-generation explosive reactive armor that will provide enhanced protection from shaped charge warheads and kinetic energy penetrators. The Aeronautical Development Establishment is developing a cost-effective loitering munition variant of the Abhyash high-speed expendable aerial target. It has a range of 100 km and an endurance of 45 minutes, and once the new variant is ready, it will be able to provide real-time intelligence to ground forces before plunging on its target if needed. It is also being planned for manned-unmanned teaming operations, as the manned aircraft can work in tandem with the Abhyas system to conduct coordinated strikes, perform reconnaissance missions, or suppress enemy air defenses. Today's top 3 comments.
Oh, my God.